Statistics from the National Environment Management Authority show that plastics take the lion's share of the waste in the country, with an estimated 600 tons of plastics produced every day. Kampala City alone accounts for large volumes of plastic waste, which is littered all over the city and in schools. In a bid to renew the fight against plastic pollution, wildlife clubs in Uganda have decided to take the Keep Environment Safe and Fight Against Plastic Pollution campaigns into schools. In these campaigns, Mr. and Miss Environment competitions for secondary schools for 2023 have been launched in Mukono. Over 10 schools participated in the hotly contested competitions that covered general knowledge, thematic questions, and general presentations on environment and wildlife.
We are facing a problem of plastics in our country, of which when plastics are burnt, they release carbon dioxide because they have hydrocarbon.
The red car represents the blood that runs through us as Africans. We can bring back our nature and it goes back.
The students showcased various ways of recycling plastics and new innovations of reducing plastic pollution through their creative attires. The students also made a commitment to use their positions to educate their peers on environment.
As looking at the world right now, there are very many plastics that are being disposed into our soils that's really degrading the earth. And this is also inspiring me to inspire the young people to come up, reduce, reuse, and recycle plastics.
The problem is not the plastics, the problem is us. Let us know where to put the plastics, let us know where to do with the plastics, and of course, we shall all live in a better world.
This is a war whereby we should dress as soldier dresses ready for war, and we are here to fight the pollution.
Mr. Tadeo Rusoke, the executive director of Wildlife Clubs in Uganda, explained that such competitions open doors for young minds to showcase their abilities to fight plastic pollution and other environment-threatening activities.
Today, Mr. and Miss Environment is part of the Post World Environment Day 2023 activities, and we are specifically doing this initiative to raise awareness, especially among the youth who are within schools, about the dangers of plastic pollution, especially the single-use plastics.
The advice we can give government is to put a total ban to all companies that are producing plastic-related materials, be it polythene and plastic bottles, plastic plates, so as to enable our environment remain healthy, even us. Because ecosystem health is a direct impact to our human health.
Dennis Ochan Odong, an environmentalist from Nkumba University, called for combined efforts to combat plastic pollution in the country, adding that taking competitions in schools is a step in the right direction.
We can change the narrative for the future, beginning with the youngsters. Our generation, as adults, we've messed up the environment, and I think we can change the narrative when we begin with the schools, the youngsters, and see that we develop the disciplines of working with reducing plastic waste.
The Miss and Mr. Environment competition in schools were organized under the theme Stop Plastics Today. Jaliet Namoya for the news.